Hello everyone, welcome to 1 minute GK. This is the 5th session of Basic Funda. In this video, we will see the difference between boiling and evaporation. So let's start our video. The first difference is on the basis of definition. Friends, boiling is the process by which a liquid turns into vapor when it is heated to its boiling point. On the other hand, the evaporation is the process of conversion of liquid into the vapor at any temperature below its boiling point. The second difference is based upon the occurrence. Guys, boiling is a bulk phenomenon, as in this process the entire liquid boils. It is associated with large mass, whereas the evaporation takes place only on the exposed surface of the liquid. Hence, it is called as a surface phenomenon. The third difference is the bubble formation. In boiling, the bubbles get formed as the vapor pressure is more than that of the atmospheric pressure. Whereas in evaporation, bubbles cannot form as the vapor pressure is less than that of the atmospheric pressure. The next difference is based upon the length of the process. Friends, boiling is faster and the evaporation is a slower process. As the evaporation is mostly natural, hence it is a slower process. The next difference is based upon the average temperature involved. For boiling, the temperature should reach to the boiling point of the liquid. On the other hand, for evaporation to take place, the temperature does not need to reach the boiling point. Hence, it can happen at any point below its boiling point. Energy. Guys, for boiling to happen, the source of energy is needed. For example, we use the LPG cylinder gasket as a source to boil water. For evaporation, the energy is supplied by surrounding, which includes the natural sources like sunlight, heat, etc. The next difference is based upon the change in temperature. In the process of boiling, the temperature remains constant, whereas in the process of evaporation, the temperature may change. The next difference is on the basis of cooling. Guys, the boiling does not produce cooling, but the evaporation produces cooling. For example, it is a technical example of the AC. When we mount the split AC, we always mount the evaporator part of that AC inside our room, and which is nothing but the part which gives the cooling effect. So guys, this was today's video. Please share it and invite your friends to join this channel. So thank you guys. Do subscribe our channel. Take care and Jai Hind.